Hania Szajewska. I'm the head of the Department of Pediatrics at the Medical University of Warsaw. And one of the research interests of our group are early strategies to prevent allergic diseases in children. One of the interventions which is commonly used is the use of hydrolyzed formula. The problem with the hydrolyzed formula is that not all hydrolyzed formula provides the same degree of protective benefit. And this is because factors such as the protein source, hydrolysis method, and degree of hydrolysis that often depend on the manufacturer contribute to the differences among hydrolysates. Very recently, we published a paper in Current Medical Research and Opinion, and the aim of this paper was to systematically review and update data on the efficacy and safety of only one type of hydrolyzed formula, and this was 100% partially hydrolyzed 100% whey formula compared with standard infant formula and extensively hydrolyzed formula in reducing the risk of allergy in healthy infants. We followed the methodology developed by Cochrane collaboration for systematic reviews and meta-analyses. We identified 15 randomized controlled trials, and we concluded, based on the pooled analysis of the data which identified, that partially hydrolyzed formula compared with the standard infant formula reduced the risk of all allergic diseases, particularly the cumulative incidence of atopic dermatitis among children at high risk of allergy. What is important is that the strongest evidence comes from a well-designed and conducted independently funded trial, which is a GINI study, German Infant Nutrition Intervention Study. So overall, the results of our updated meta-analysis do support current recommendations for the use of hydrolyzed formula with documented efficacy for preventing allergic diseases in children.